down at the table and wait for the kettle to let out a cry. And I make for the cupboard and pull out a mug that I hold to the light. And then I knock a couple pans aside and fall into the chair inside. And the dog leans up against my side, and mostly this is how it always happens. So I reach for the phone and I flick through the moments and step outside. And I lean through the window to listen, but silence is all I find. And then I turn back to my tablet with a question about time. It says in just a couple minutes I can get back to my life. So I look at the clock but see its hands are tied. Lean over the stove and feel the heat beneath me rise. Lift up the kettle to nothing happening inside and set it back down on the fire again. Return to the stories from the weekend. So I'm back at the table and tracing my fingers on the knotty pine. Then they tap with the second hand, which still hasn't moved from the night. And then I march back to the garden, but then think I hear a sign. And then pace back to the kitchen, where there's nothing new I find. And then I look to the second hand, that's still not at the nine. And falling slouch into the kitchen chair, and wield another sigh. And then tumble to the living room to kill a little time. And pace back through the kitchen to the garden yet another time. I look at the clock and I'm convinced it's live. I don't remember this ever taking so much time. I've got places to be, a schedule to meet, people to see, and nothing could be as useless and aggravating to me. And there's not even anything new in my feet. Mind, the movements of the mind from the day into the night. There's no moment that is mine. Everything in life, everything in time. All I ever do is mine. The movements of the life from the day into the night. There's no moment that is mine. Everything in life. Nothing really has changed.